Hello and welcome to this tutorial on updating iTunes work and movement fields easily with SongKong. iTunes now supports movements and works for classical music, but does not provide any way to automatically add data to these fields. So if you're using iTunes as an editor, it becomes very time consuming to add this new data. So if we take this classical music album that we've already loaded into iTunes, we can see from the titles that clearly tracks 1 to 5 are from one particular work, Suite for Orchestra number 3, and tracks 6 to 12 are for a different work, Suite for Orchestra number 1. But the interface is very cluttered at the moment because we have to add all that information into the track title. Now, iTunes has these work, movement and movement name fields that can be used to group songs by the work in addition to grouping songs by the album. But there's not an easy way within iTunes to put that data in. But luckily, both SongKong and JCOS can now add this data for you automatically, and this guide explains how this works for SongKong. So for the purpose of this guide, I've created an iTunes database consisting of three albums, two classical albums and one regular rock pop album. And as you can see, all of them just have a regular track listing at the moment, and there's no work or movement information. So let's fire up SongKong. We've selected the folder where the music is stored. We make sure we have saved changes to iTunes checked. That informs iTunes when a song that is in its library has had its metadata updated. We've configured it here to only update the fields we're interested in, but of course you could use it to update all your fields. And with various classical options, but if we just use the defaults, that does exactly what we need it to do for this tutorial. So press start. SongKong is going away and find decoding this information for these songs and then informing iTunes of the changes it has made. We just wait for that to finish and then it will create a report. So here we can see the 12 tracks have all been modified. If you remember, tracks 1 to 5 are from one particular work and tracks 6 to 12 are for a different work. So we look at any of the tracks from 1 to 5. They have added the work information and the number of movements in that work and their particular movement number. And the movement title. If we go to a track that was on work 2, we can see we have a different work, we have a different movement total because there's more movements on this work, and then we have the movement number within this work. Okay, let's go and have a look at iTunes now. The first thing is we can see that the work information has been added, as has the movement and movement name. But it's only been added for the classical albums. No change for our regular rock pop album. If we then go and look at the albums themselves, we can now see that iTunes has introduced a new level called the work underneath the album title and has grouped the movements under that work. So the movement no longer needs to display all the work information because that is implied by being part of the work grouping. And iTunes also displays the movement number as a Roman numeral version of the movement number we added. So we can see those ones there. For this particular album has three different works. If we look at the other album, which we looked at in SongKong, that just has the two works. So that is basically it. The only one gotcha that I wanted to show you was that sometimes the work and movement information can be added, but there's no actual change to the display in the albums view. And that is because of a new option within iTunes. Called use and work and movement. If this option isn't enabled, then there would be no changes in how the how the songs look in the album view. So if I turn it off, we still keep our work and movement information, but if we go back to the album now, it just looks like a regular album with no work information. If we go back and re-enable, and no, you can re-enable for all the songs in one go, and it will only have effect for songs that actually have work and movement, so you don't have to do it one album at a time. We re-enable that and go back. We can now see split up by work. And that's basically it. So if you imagine you've got a large collection of classical music, SongKong should be able to identify the vast majority of that music and correctly add the work and movement information, plus many other things as well.